Hi everyone, I hope you had a really great Christmas. I thought for a different kind of lesson today, we would read a story picture book about some people that met Jesus only a week after he had been born. After Jesus was born, Mary and Joseph took him to the temple like they were supposed to do. And when they got there, there were two people who had been waiting a very, very long time to meet Jesus. One of them was named Simeon and the other one was named Anna. We're going to read the story about Anna today. Back in the days when Christ was born, a woman came to stay in the temple in Jerusalem. She prayed there night and day. Her name was Anna. She lived alone for 80 years or more. Her husband died when she was young and she was very poor. See this picture here? Let's see. She really had to be quite old, I'd guess almost 100. She had the power to prophesy and often sat and wondered. She knew the Lord would come to earth. She often saw this vision. She knew that he would die for us. To share this was her mission. Each day she talked to those who came into the church to pray. The Lord is coming very soon, perhaps this very day. He'll save Jerusalem and all of us who wait here. For him, he'll take all of our sins away to worship and adore him. The people smiled at Anna's words, but they weren't really hearing. Still, Anna knew that he would come. She trusted, never fearing. These people listened for a while, but then they walked away, and Anna once again returned to wander through the day. I wonder if he'll be a king, if I will live to see him, she wondered as each boy was brought to church if it might be him. But as parents brought their sons to bless, she knew that none was Jesus, the Son of God, our Savior dear, whose death forever frees us. So Anna was in Jerusalem when Joseph and Mary came to Bethlehem with all of those who had King David's name. She didn't know they could not find a special place to stay, that the best they found that holy night was an old barn filled with hay. And she didn't hear the angels sing to shepherds poor and cold. She didn't hear the words of peace and joy those angels told. She didn't get to go with them into that tiny stable, but I believe she would have gone if only she'd been able. No, Anna wasn't there that night. She missed the angel's song, but somehow she still knew that she would see him before long. She also missed the star that shined on high that Christmas night. She didn't see the child that lay beneath that brilliant light. She didn't go to Bethlehem with the wise men who came there. She didn't see them kneel and give their gifts so fine and rare. She rode no mighty camel's back as those famous men. She didn't come from some strange land and then go home again. But she knew somehow that God had given to her the gift to share. She told all those that came to church of God's great love and care. And though she missed the angels' songs and never saw the star, she knew that God would send his son to this world from afar. And then, one day, as she was praying, a happy couple came to get a blessing of their son, and Jesus was his name. She watched when Simeon took the child. He was old as she. He thanked the Lord that he had lived long enough to see. The baby that he held and blessed, she knew this was the one. She hurried forward just as fast as her old legs could run. As Simeon finished his words of joy and his voice filled all the hall, our God be praised, this is his son who's come to save us all. All you who look for freedom from this ugly world of sorrow, this is the Lord, he's here today, don't wait until tomorrow. He'll die to save us from our sins, but from the grave he'll rise, and in heaven he'll make a home for us high above the skies. No doubt the people wondered when they heard what Anna spoke. Some might have thought she spoke the truth, but most thought it was a joke. But as we now look back today, we know her words are true. This woman showed a living faith in God to me and you. Like her, we missed the song and star on that first Christmas night, but we have seen their message grow much louder and more bright. I forgot to show you this other page. That's the story of Anna. She met Jesus only when he was 8 days old, and she was so glad to see him. Follow that star. Are you ready? Let's read it. Look, see that star? Where do you think they saw the star? In the sky. See that star sparkle? That star is for Jesus. Let's follow that star. Look at those camels. They look pretty fancy. Let's see Jesus. Bumpity bump, bumpity bump, they rode. Do you think they went fast? They went fast, woo, so fast to see Jesus. Where is Jesus? See that star? See that star sparkle? Can you see the star in the corner? I think they were asking that man if he knew where Jesus was. Follow that star. Bumpity bump, bumpity bump, they rode. That star is for Jesus. Off they go, following the star. Very fast. Let's follow that star. Bumpity bump, bumpity bump, they rode. They rode to see Jesus. That star! That star! Look at where the star is. Can you see? Can you see what it's pointing towards? Maybe that's where Jesus is. Let's find out. Where is Jesus? They see Jesus. Do they see picture in Jesus in this picture? No. Look at Jesus. Do they see Jesus in this picture? Yes, they do. And what did they have for Jesus? They had some special gifts for him, didn't they? They went to worship Jesus. That's our first story. Our next story is another way to tell about the wise men. Here we go, the visit of the wise men. This book's a little heavier. Long ago and far away, some thinkers very wise, each evening watched the sun go down, they watched the starry skies. They knew the moon, they knew each star, they studied planets too. The wise men drew their charts and maps, their wisdom grew and grew. You see them looking at the stars with their window? One night, as darkness dimmed, the light and stars began to shine. Appeared a brand new star to them, a star so big and fine. The wise men knew a special joy. They shouted, prepare. The star can only mean one thing. A king is born. But where? They left their homes to find that king. They carried gifts of love. Their star shone brightly on their way, a brilliant guide above. 'Twas Jesus whom they rightly sought. 'Twas Herod whom they found. The king of all Jerusalem, the meanest man around. The wise men asked King Herod, "Where, oh, where's this newborn king? We want to worship him with love. To him our praises sing."
Do you think Herod looks very happy?
Not so happy. He wanted to be the only king. But wicked Herod couldn't say where Jesus had been born. He did not know. He could not tell what happened Christmas morn. So Herod told his scholars, "You must look for all your worth in every book and scroll to learn the place of kingly birth." They answered, "Yes, in Bethlehem, King David's family town. That must be where this babe lives now." King Herod hid his frown. That awful king paced back and forth. He was a jealous man. "Another king will take my crown," he thought. Then he made a plan. "Please go and find this king," he said. "Then hurry back and say exactly where he lives so I can worship him someday." King Herod's very wicked heart had blurted out this lie. He'd never worship Jesus Christ. He wanted him to die. The wise men left Jerusalem to go to Bethlehem, and in the darkened sky they saw the star still guiding them. So they rejoiced with happy hearts. With hope they traveled fast. Until they saw the star stand still, they found the child at last.
Look at that. They found him.
In front of Jesus, bowing down, they praised their Savior Lord. With gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh, he was adored.
They gave him some very special gifts.
Then in a dream that night they heard the voice of God say, "Go, go back home another way, but not to Herod, no." The wise men did what God had said, though Herod's anger grew. For Jesus, Savior, Son of God, had godly work to do. You see, this babe was born to be our perfect, sinless Lord, who would give his life for all and who is by all adored. Well, that's all I have for my stories today. Thanks for listening to my stories and looking at the picture books with me. It's so neat to know that not only were people visiting Jesus right when he was born, they came afterwards too. The wise men brought him gifts to celebrate Jesus had been born. Oh, I hope you had a great Christmas, everyone, and I can't wait to see you soon. I hope you have a great time, everyone, this week. Enjoy your time off, and I'll see you soon. Bye, everyone!